Hello ladies and gentlemen who are taking a surfing course to get ready for the second wave. We are here today to help the Israeli tourism after the corona and show how beautiful the beaches are. Israel was always a G-spot for tourists from around the world because of the lovely beaches we have. This year you can enjoy the young Israelis who are not flying to Hagia Napa to be ambassadors of the beautiful Israeli and meet British tourists. We are here at the Pickers Beach where a famous film was filmed celebrating the years before Me Too with the famous sentences opposite Gute, opposite, who will pay? Benon will pay. It will come to you, trust me, it will come to you. You can also go to the Jerusalem Beach, which is a very surprising name for a town with no beach. It is like putting a tsunami warning in Switzerland. But where else can you find such charmantic Israeli men, like the man with the popsicle who says, I'm walking? People playing gentle badminton with a strong hand chapter spoon quietly. The Israeli beaches are the perfect ecosystem tool to divorce you from your money. Food is at prices that are equal to any soul, but only if your soul is willing to sell a kidney. If you feel that you have paid too much for a bottle of water, you can always complain to our water minister, Wolf Alkin. At the Israeli beach, you can see people with a radically small bathing suit that shows how Jewish they are. We have our version of David Hasselhoff working 2 hours a day, 2 months a year, using the Israeli invention, the small lettuce boat called Chasake. You probably heard the famous chanson, Chasake, Chasake, without a porch and a balcony. When you sit in the sun, you can decide how you want your body cooked. If you're French, you can go en flambé. And if you're Anglo-Saxon, you're probably going well done. The water is dangerous, but in the Mediterranean, there is no discrimination. Everybody can drown, but there is handyman discrimination for Arabs and Orthodox Jews. So welcome to all the tourists. We are waiting for you to recover our economy.